revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Together, we will change Gotham. Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, I'm eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette. Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Your father knew which hands to shake.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal? It's dangerous.
This is Selina.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces. Falcone's calling card.
The chemicals. Where are they?
We're all being played in, couldn't you? It's the Waynes. Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
You don't have to do this.
Only you now, Master Bruce.
I thought I might find you here. The news was upsetting for both of us.
But you should see this.
I know you come here for solitude, Bruce.
More allegations about his ties to the underworld.
This isn't going away.
It's all so public and messy.
People are throwing stones at my family, Alfred. I need to understand why.
It's my family, too. Don't forget that. I've been dreading this day for nearly two decades. I hoped it would never come.
Forget the papers. I want to hear it from you.
The truth is, they were billionaires, Bruce. You can't amass that kind of wealth without making certain moral compromises. It's just not possible. That kind of money taints you.
You kept their secrets for them.
I'm trying to help you understand.
Then try harder!
Hill greased the wheels of politics. Falcone was the muscle. Thomas legitimized the whole enterprise with his name. Your father, Hamilton Hill, and Falcone, they were partners. Nothing happened in Gotham without them knowing.
Falcone, the papers, they were telling the truth. Everyone knew about this but me.
I know it's a lot to take in. I want you to know, I had my suitcases ready. I couldn't stand to be around your father anymore. But then, they were killed, and you were all alone. And I just couldn't walk out the door. Everything I did, everything I've ever done, was out of love for you. I hope you can forgive me.
How could I hold this against you? You're all I've got, Alfred.
Thank you. I won't let you down again. This is the first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you, I thought they'd finally arrested your father. I couldn't believe a low-life thug like Joe Chill would have the audacity to rob and kill Thomas Wayne. He was simply too well known. Too big. Yet, there it was.
If my father was that deep in crime, he would have had enemies.
Well, it's a fair assumption. You don't think? You always said it was a simple mugging. In 20 years, you've never wavered from that story.
I can recall every moment of that night in vivid detail. But maybe that's wrong.
Sometimes we block out things we don't want to face.
Maybe there was some detail I overlooked. I want him standing here, right now.
And what would the Batman do with his own parents' killer?
The possibilities are frightening.
I'd only want to ask him one question. Why? My parents could have given him anything. Why would he just shoot them?
He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce.
Invincible. Sadly, he was mistaken.
I can't picture him as a criminal, not the kind I deal with.
In that moment, he was simply your father.
That movie. Saw it countless times at that theater. How long did it play there?
Only when you wanted to see it, Bruce. Your mother arranged the special screenings personally.
I never knew that. She was always so good to me.
Where exactly does the memory end?
With my father pleading, "You don't have to do this." And the gun fires.
And after that? There are considerable gaps in that recollection.
Maybe. Do I really want to know?
Bruce, are you all right?
It wasn't a mugging. They were assassinated. And Carmine Falcone knows why.